I'm setting up a workshop area here in the basement, and I've got my old 18-inch bandsaw and my old table saw, and both of those require 240 volts, so I want to put an electrical socket for that here, and I need to run a wire to that from the breaker panel, which is back here. The first thing I'm doing is to run a wire from the breaker panel to where I want the socket. It's quite a bit of work snaking all that wire through all the joists. I should have started in the middle and worked towards both ends. I'm using a number 12 Romex wire with a red sheath. This type of wire is normally used for 240 volt heater circuits, and the main difference is that it has a black and a red conductor instead of a black and a white conductor. Black wire is always used for hot, and white always indicates neutral. Red can be something else, such as another hot. In this case, both black and red are hot because they're alternate phases of a 240 volt circuit. I had glued two 2x4s together to form an L to fit around the post, and that gives me a place to mount the socket to and also helps to protect the wire. You can cut machine screw threads in wood, but you can also use wood screws on metal. Here I'm drilling a 1/8 inch pilot hole through the metal post, and drywall screws are just a tiny bit larger than that and also much harder than the post, so the drywall screw will screw in and hold itself quite nicely in that metal hole. Now, one thing that gets people confused is where do you get the 240 volts from? Because if I measure from ground to here where the breakers connect, it's 123 volts, and on here as well. But these two bars are always opposed to each other, so that between the two of them, we actually get the 240 volts. So here's my 240 volt breaker, and that connects to two of those bars there. So between the two of them, it gets the 240 volts. By the way, if you don't turn off the mains when you put one of these breakers in, it's best to put it in the off position because you're likely to touch the screws while you plug it in. And I'm working on a live breaker panel here, which means if I touch this part here and I touch ground at the same time, I could get zapped. So I have to be careful not to touch this and this at the same time. And why work on a live breaker panel? Well, if I turned off all the electricity, it would be dark in here and that would make terrible video. Yay, I got the power! After filming the installation of this circuit, I added 8 more 120 volt sockets. And those are actually off of 1 3 conductor wire using opposite phases. The red one and the black one are the opposite phases and they share a neutral. And that way I get twice as much juice that I can get out of here. And the neutral actually never gets overloaded even though it's shared because those two phases are opposite. So if they're both loaded, the load on the neutral is actually canceled. And having a few machines and a tools area in the basement is really handy because it means I don't have to walk all the way over to the shop every time I want to cut something. For the time being, I've got a rat's nest of extension cords and lamps up here, which no doubt the safety Nellies will say, oh, that's unsafe, it's overloading, blah, blah, blah. But these are actually all LED bulbs, about 8 watts apiece. So all of those lights together actually use up less power than one conventional 100 watt bulb. And hopefully I'll get this area set up enough that I can do simple projects down here. And that way, if the kids are going nuts, I can just come upstairs and help. Because if I'm way over in the workshop, I don't hear anything.